Liquidity is the collective expression of opinions on the market. The more opinions that are expressed in the form of open buy and sell orders, the more liquid the product is likely to be. Traders use liquidity as a key indicator to know how much of a product they can trade and what it will cost to trade it. It allows them to get in and out of the market quickly, efficiently, and cost-effectively.
Developed by CME Data Science, the interactive CME liquidity tool visualizes three critical factors that help you understand the liquidity dynamics before entering a new market or a new trade. The bid-ask spread, which is the difference between the price quoted for purchase and the price quoted to sell the product. Book depth, which is the number of contracts in buy orders and sell orders at a given price level. And the cost to trade, which is the amount it will cost in ticks equal to the minimum bid-ask spread to buy or sell a specific order size. You can view current or historical product liquidity to understand the trends and patterns over time and focus on the trading hours of different time zones. Let's take a look at how this dynamic tool works by selecting the E-mini S&P 500 futures contract from October 2nd through November 21st, 2017, during Chicago trading hours. The bid-ask spread analysis shows the difference in ticks between the price that a buyer is willing to pay and the price that a seller is willing to accept. Here, we've selected bid-ask spread and top of book. You can alternatively also select up to 10 levels of the central limit order book. This shows that the E-mini S&P 500 bid-ask spread ranged from 1 to 1.0013. One tick typically means that you would incur the minimum market cost to trade the product.
This means there was a one-tick market for 99.87% in the period selected.
The book depth indicates the number of contracts that are available to buy or sell at each price level. The tool shows up to 10 levels of the order book. Again, this signals how liquid the product is, since the higher the number of orders at each price, the deeper the market.
Here at the top of the book for the E-mini S&P 500 contract, there are around 500 contracts on the bid and 500 contracts on the ask during this time range.
Finally, the cost to trade analysis is one of the most significant gauges of product liquidity. In the CME liquidity tool, the cost to trade illustrates how much it would have cost in ticks to buy or sell a specific lot size, with the cost being the difference between the bid and ask prices. The tool allows you to select up to 4 different lot sizes to quickly determine the largest lot size you could trade at the minimum market costs. So, for our example, our cost to trade 100 E-mini S&P 500 contracts is 1.005 ticks, which means the product's bid-ask spread was 1 tick wide for about 99.5% of the time, and 2 ticks wide for about 0.5% of the time. Other features of the tool offer flexibility that lets you control the type and level of detail that's displayed. You can switch the period of the day among Chicago, London, and Singapore to compare liquidity around the clock, view bid-ask spreads, cost to trade, and book depth across different granularities by day, week, month, quarter, or year. Add a second chart or overlay them to make easy comparisons.
Finally, you can download chart images to share with customers or colleagues.
The CME liquidity tool significantly enhances your ability to plan hedging or trading strategies and to estimate the cost associated with them. In addition, since the tool is mobile-friendly, you have easy access to valuable liquidity data at your fingertips. All you need is a CME login to get started. For more information, visit cmegroup.com.